This is a typical halftime show. But Sunday is not your typical game, nor typical performance.
We just are really happy to have the opportunity.
The Minnesota Orchestra will be your halftime entertainment when the Vikes and Packs square off at U.S. Bank. If you're envisioning tubas and timpanis and bassists running down the sidelines, you're not far off. The 70-piece ensemble has 2 minutes to get on the field, followed by an 8-minute performance.
What are people going to see at the game? Because it's not going to be like a regular stage performance. This is the NFL. I know it's going to be bigger and kind of badder than that, right?
Well, first of all, yeah, it's going to be very different than one would see in Orchestra Hall for a couple reasons. First of all, it's a huge place. It's a huge arena. And also, there needs to be a very strong visual content to it. So I think they've really come up with computer mapping, using the field itself as the projection screen, and including the orchestra set up as part of that whole projection area. It really integrates visually the orchestra performance into the other visuals, which are extremely compelling. They're very exciting.
So it'll look kind of like the opening ceremony of the Olympics a little bit, where you
see that. It will be similar. It's certainly the same type of technology applied.
What are we going to hear? What are they going to play?
Well, I'm not at liberty to tell you, but there is there's classical elements to it, and then there's a Prince piece of it as well.
What Prince song are you going to play?
I can't tell you.
A medley?
Oh, I can't tell you that either. I have been sworn to secrecy.
2 years ago, this would have been impossible. A labor dispute turned musician lockout grabbed national headlines. The famous conductor, Osmo Vanska, quit. It was not good.
So I arrived after that was all resolved, and at that point there was we were just getting back on our feet and putting things back together, and that's happened much more quickly and more powerfully than we would have even hoped.
He's right. Osmo's back in the driver's seat. The orchestra made an historic trip to Cuba last year. And this summer, a European tour in old Viking territory. Now back to celebrate a new Vikings stadium.
I think the fans are going to love it. So we're come Sunday, we'll be ready to play. We're ready to go.
Unfortunately, unless you're a ticket holder, you're not going to be able to see the performance because they're not going to show it on NBC.
Oh, that's right.
What? Yeah, the halftime. Yeah, we're not going to be able to see it. But it's going to be cool. And if you don't think classical music goes with football, all you got to do is go back to those old films in the 60s and 70s, the NFL films, where all it was classical music to football highlights, right?
Are they going to run with like those big instruments off the field?
Yeah, they got 2 minutes to get on and off. So imagine
even the harp?
Some man or woman with a bass just trying to lug it off. No harp. No, the harp won't be there.
I think it's exciting. Heavy. I like that they're doing something different.
I think it's cool.
Yeah. I love it.
I want to see.
Awesome.
It.
Thank you, Chris.
Yep.
All right, thanks, Chris. Well, just in case Care 11 hasn't made this real clear, the game will be on the 11 Sunday night. But for those who dig into that multi-screen jam and want to play social and watch the game, Twitter has sealed the deal to live stream Thursday night football games. The new Twitter TV app will be available on Apple TV, Amazon.